when I had gone to Congo as a part of the medical team to do a camp over there from Fortis Hospital. I happened to meet this lady first time in the month of May. Mama Chibi, you just cannot miss her. She's a big, chubby lady, chirpy, talking all the time. I was seeing the patients in the OPD, just then I heard a shout, Mama Chibi has fallen. So we all rushed towards the OPD area where Mama Chibi was lying on the floor, all sprawled out, and apparently she had sprained her ankle. But one look at it and you knew that it's broken. It was a hospital, they had an orthopedic surgeon team. We discussed the case over them with the x-rays and it was decided that it will need surgery. Mama Chibi wanted to come to India, Delhi, for the surgery of the ankle. And we told her, look, this is a simple fracture, you don't need surgery for that. I mean, you don't need to come to India for that surgery, but if you want to come at all, then I'll do both, knee as well as ankle. Because for the simple fact, the cause of the fall and the fracture of the ankle was secondary to the unstable knee. So if you're coming all the way to India, it's better that we fix the knee joint also. After a week, we got a call that she's planning to come to India.
On m'a bien reçu avec mon docteur Kota. Et je suis arrivée. J'ai quitté Kinshasa le dimanche 13. Je suis arrivée ici le lundi 14 octobre et le 15 octobre, on m'a opérée. J'étais admise ici à l'hôpital le 14 octobre et le 15 octobre, on m'a opérée.
When she first came to us, she was basically on a wheelchair. And with complaining of basically severe pain in her knee joints, there was a lack of mobility in her knee joints. She had a history of ankle fracture and a spinal surgery had been done to her a year ago.
Once she got convinced that perhaps she has been getting trouble with this knee for past 3 years, number one. Number two, this is going to cause further falls, which is going to affect her mobility. Number three, the local doctors, they were not forthcoming in performing a surgery on the ankle fracture, which was a simple, straightforward. Fourthly, I had already said, if you come to India, Delhi, it has to be both the procedures, not single one.
Je disais ceci. Dans le monde, on connaît pour les technologies. On connaît Chine, Brésil et l'Inde. Mais chaque fois, on dit que la technologie de l'Inde est en top. Okay. Voilà, est en top. Bango baleki bango nyo somayel. Baleki bao yomi bale wana technologie na bango emati.
Now all the reports came positive. So by that time, we had cleared up the joint totally, completely, and it was decided to go for definitive surgery then and there. So we put a definitive implant. The problem again, one is of infection, the second is of bone loss. So we landed up with substantial amount of bone loss in that area. We have some very good implants, very good sleeves by which we were able to, let's say, compensate for this bone loss. And at the end of about 3.5 hours, we were able to get a good stable joint. Now, that was the first part, joint gone. Now, it comes to the term of the ankle joint. Old lady, 70 years plus, already undergone a major procedure, 3.5 hours. Now, it's time for the ankle joint. We took a call. The anesthetist, we had a long discussion with them. They said, you know, it's okay. Patient is behaving well. We can take a chance. We can do the ankle also in the same sitting. And when we opened up the ankle, we realized it was already a month old or something. It was half sticky. It was a huge effort to, you know, make the fragments loose, put them back in the position and try to fix them. Anyway, I think about 6 hours of total surgical duration, we were safe and sound. We all came out and then started the long process of rehab, which took us about almost 2 weeks of regular trips to physiotherapy department an hour to 1.5 hours of regular sessions. But I'm glad that she was willing. She withstood the efforts. She was, I mean, so motivated, I'm sure.
Immediately after the surgery, she was not able to take the weight on her legs. We had to take the support of two therapists and a walker to really make her stand the very first day. But gradually, with the strengthening of the muscles and teaching her proper body mechanics, like to keep her back straight and everything, she is now able to walk independently with the walker, and even without the support, she's able to move inside the room.
Et je remercie l'hôpital Fortis, sans oublier le pays de l'Inde qui nous reçoit avec gentillesse, les médecins, les infirmiers, tout le monde nous reçoit avec plaisir. Je remercie en tout cas les pays aussi.
The other type of patients who should be showcased and shown to our other patients also, okay, look, if you have a problem, there's always a solution, provided you're also willing to work out for it.